Of all the maids in fair Scotland, the fairest was Marjorie. Young Benjie was her own true love, and a dear true love was he. And oh, but they were lovers dear, and loved full constantly. But aye, the more when they fell out, the sorer was their plea. And they have quarrelled upon a day, till Marjorie's heart grew woe. She said she'd choose another love, and let young Benjie go. And he was stout and proud-hearted, and thought on it bitterly. And he is gone by the wan moonlight to meet his Marjorie. Then soft she smiled and said to him, "Oh, what ill have I done?" He took her in his arms too and threw her o'er the linn. The stream was strong, the maid was stout, and loath to be drowned. But ere she won the Loudon banks, her fair colour was won. Then up and spoke her eldest brother, "Oh, see now you what I see." And up and spoke her younger brother, "It's our sister Marjorie." And they've ta'en up the comely corpse and laid it upon the ground. Oh, who has killed our own sister, and how may he be found? The night it is her low-like wake, the morn her burial day, and we mourn watch at mirk midnight to hear what she may say. About the middle of the night, the cocks began to crow, and at the mid-hour of the night, the corpse began to throw. Oh, who has done this deed, sister? Who dared this deadly sin? Who was so stout and feared no doubt as throw you o'er the linn? Young Benjie was the only man that did my body win. He was so stout and proud-hearted, he threw me o'er the linn. Shall we young Benjie head, sister? Shall we young Benjie hang? Or shall we pike out his two grey een and punish him ere he gang? Oh, ye mourn a Benjie head, brothers, ye mourn a Benjie hang, but ye may pike out his two grey een and punish him ere he gang. Tie a green cravat around his neck and lead him out and in, and the best a servant about your house to wait young Benjie on. And I at every 7 years' end, you'll take him to the linn. And that's the penance he must endure to ease his deadly sin.